The aerodynamic force is a force exerted on a body by the air and depends on the relative motion between the air and the body. Drag is the force component parallel to the direction of the relative motion. Lift is the force component perpendicular to the direction of relative motion. The Magnus effect is the result of a lift force acting on a spinning object. The deflection is caused by the difference in pressure of the fluid on opposite sides of the spinning object. The strength of the Magnus effect is dependent on the speed of rotation of the object. Backspin can make balls fly further. Dimples, like in golf balls, can increase lift caused by backspin. Spin rate will increase lift but also drag. The increase in drag combined with the relatively high drag coefficient of the sphere doesn't make it a good option for long-range slinging. Slinging with backspin has its own difficulties as it requires vertical overhand releases and the stone may not release cleanly because the release cord is in the way. With backspin, a lower release angle should be preferred because of the climb and the slightly increased drag. The benefit of the backspin on spherical ammo is that it doesn't cause any deflection to the sides, unless of course you put sidespin. If the sphere is released with rifle spin, the spinning axis is aligned with the initial trajectory. Downrange there will be an increase of the angle between the spin axis and the trajectory. Because of the Magnus effect, this will cause a deflection to the left for right-hand spin. Lift due to angle of attack. For longer shapes, like ellipsoids, the angle of attack creates lift. Lift and drag will increase between 0 and 15 degrees. After that, there is flow separation on the back surface, which increases drag and reduces lift. The best option is slinging with 0 angle of attack. This will keep initial drag as low as possible. And downrange, this angle will change with the trajectory, and we will get the benefits there. But first, let's talk about the center of pressure and center of mass. Center of mass will generally be in the center of the projectile. Egg-shaped or asymmetrical ammo will move it forwards. Center of pressure is the point where all the aerodynamic forces can be assumed to act. It is the equivalent of the center of gravity for the mass of a body. The center of pressure moves to the front as angle of attack increases. Center of pressure is in front of the center of mass of most projectiles. The moment arm created between the center of pressure and center of mass normally causes projectiles to tumble. This can be prevented by spin stabilization. Other ways of stabilization is adding fins to move the center of pressure behind the center of mass. Sling projectiles have spin rates of 3600 to 15000 RPM. This spin rate can stabilize long projectiles. As the projectile travels downrange, following a parabolic trajectory, the spin axis will try to remain in the same orientation. This creates an increasing angle of attack downrange. If we were in a vacuum, the final orientation would be the same as the initial orientation at release, and the projectile would belly flop on the target. But the fluid forces generate moments and cause the body to reorient itself. Enter precession. Precession is a change in the orientation of the rotational axis of a rotating body. Precession is the result of a torque on a spinning object. Pushing a spinning disc on one side will move the disc 90 degrees later. What we see as movement is the points that have gained max speed from the force we applied. We can't see max force, only feel it. When we apply force on one side, the force on the other side has the opposite direction. Max speed is when these forces cancel out, or torque is zero, and acceleration is zero. This is on the axis of the torque, which passes through the center of mass of the disc. The same thing can be explained as a change in the direction of angular momentum in the direction of the torque applied. Now, if we were to push a sling projectile on the nose, the displacement would be 90 degrees later because of precession. Spin drift is insignificant in small caliber rifles, but it is important in artillery and slinging. What's common between the two is high spin rates, big drop, and long projectiles. Spin drift is the result of the aerodynamic force acting on the center of pressure of a spinning projectile. The moment created by the distance between the center of pressure and center of mass reorients the projectile as it travels downrange. Here you can see the results of releasing at different initial angles of attack. This is not optimal. Initial zero angle of attack is the best. As you can understand, there are way too many parameters to calculate, but spin drift is not random. With ammo consistency, it is easy to compensate. Spin drift can move the trajectory to your point of view, while Magnus drift of spherical ammo will move it away. Spin drift is the result of a balance of different forces and the change of angles. Gravity pulls the projectile in a parabola, and with the spin stabilization, an angle of attack is created. The angle of attack creates a lift force, which counteracts gravity and reorients the projectile to the right through precession. The new yaw angle changes the vector of the lift force, which starts to reorient the projectile point down, decreasing the angle of attack. When there is a positive angle of attack, there is also a component of the Magnus force, pulling the projectile initially to the left. When a yaw angle is acquired from the lift force precession, the Magnus force starts to point up. The precession caused by the Magnus force reorients the projectile initially to a positive angle of attack and then to the right, a yaw angle. The balance of spin rate, drop rate, lift, Magnus force, drag, and spin decay will determine the flight and stability of a projectile. Tuning. The shape of ammo can be viewed as arrow spine. Archers tune the arrow spine stiffness to make the arrow bend around the bow and go straight. Slingers also can tune the ratio and shape of their ammo to remain in a straight path. You can imagine that if very long projectiles go to the right and spheres go to the left, there is a ratio where balance between lift and Magnus force is achieved, resulting in a trajectory without drift. Spin decay will affect all the parameters of the spin drift. Flattening. Slightly flattening a projectile decreases frontal area and increases the area that increases lift. This simple change will decrease pressure drag and increase lift and spin decay. Material density should be taken into account when modifying the shape for increased lift. Lower density makes a bigger projectile for the same mass, and this will make the projectile more sensitive to lift. Modifications to increase lift would be more beneficial with denser materials. The oval shape seems to follow the same rules of length to width ratio. It could increase range by shortening the moment arm of lift, but too short could lower stability and make a left drift.
Did you get any of that?